Ingredients for carbonara sauce. 1 pound of rigatoni. I like these the best, but spaghetti also ties in nicely with this sauce, as does cheese tortellini. But they're heavier in substance, and if these were used, I would recommend a small portion as maybe an appetizer. 1 cup of grated Parmesan cheese. 8 ounces of pancetta, sliced medium and cut lengthwise. 6 egg yolks placed in a small bowl and kept at room temperature. 3 tablespoons of butter at room temperature. 1 tablespoon of parsley chopped fine, half of the sauce and half of the garnish. 1 teaspoon of black pepper, half of the sauce and half of the garnish. To begin our carbonara sauce, bring 6 quarts of salted water to a boil. Now it's time to brown your pancetta, which is nothing more than Italian bacon. And if you wanted to, you could use American bacon or any kind of bacon, Chinese, Canadian, whatever. But my first choice is always pancetta, although I do enjoy it with American bacon once in a while. The smokiness of the American adds a nice touch, but it is high in fat, and you'd want to discard half the fat before putting it into your sauce. In a large, non-stick heated frying pan on medium, add your pancetta, and you want to stir it constantly so that it browns uniformly. This is going to take about 10 minutes. You want to cook it until it is almost crispy. While we're cooking the pancetta, a little story. It is said by some people that carbonara was made for the very first time in Rome, specifically in Piazza Campo dei Fiori, which means Field of Flower Square. A chef named Carbonara, who owned a restaurant by that name during World War II, created this, and you can still eat there today, especially penne alla carbonara. Pretty impressive to have such a popular Italian dish named after you and your restaurant, and still be serving it today in the same exact spot where you first invented it over 60 years ago. As the story goes, American soldiers were encamped in the square. Food was scarce, especially fresh products like meat and vegetables. And my guess is that it was winter because someone is always growing tomatoes somewhere in Italy. Nevertheless, the restaurant had a pot of fresh parsley on the windowsill, plenty of dry pasta and spices, but that was about it. In comes the cavalry. You see, the Americans had plenty of rations, dry eggs and canned bacon, U.S. bacon, that is. So Signore Carbonara went to work, and I thank him to this day for coming up with this sauce. Back to work. Now that the pancetta is brown, your water is almost at a boil. It's time for action. You need to have everything ready to go for this sauce before you drop the pasta. Remember, once you drop the pasta in the water, depending on what kind of pasta you're using, you have 10 to 12 minutes until this sauce comes together. Actually, you make it come together. So don't drop that pasta until you're ready and your guests are ready to eat. That means table set, wine open, no cell phones. Okay, 1, 2, 3, drop your pasta. Now it's time to show off in front of your friends, although I would definitely recommend you practice this a couple of times before you have guests over. Now melt the butter in a frying pan with the pancetta and add 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper. Before draining the pasta, remove and reserve 1 cup of the water. Now drain the pasta. After the pasta is completely drained, place the pasta quickly into a ceramic bowl. Add the egg yolks, 1/2 cup of the grated Parmesan cheese, 1/2 teaspoon of parsley, and the star of the show, the pancetta, scraping every bit from the pan. Now add 1/2 the reserve water and stir until a creamy consistency is reached. Add more water if necessary. Garnish with the rest of the parsley and black pepper. Do this quickly and serve immediately. After your guests have plated their pasta, top with the rest of the Parmesan cheese. You might think that the black pepper is excessive, but other people say that the name carbonara actually comes from the amount of pepper used, as it reminded people of coal dust. Carbonara actually means one who handles coal, from the word carbon. But I like the more romantic version with the Americans. Now dig in and enjoy.